Much as the government has implemented several initiatives to promote and grow use of digital services, the Internet Society Uganda chapter is bothered that the high cost of internet and smartphones is still hindering the efforts to digitize the economy. They have come out strongly to further push for the lower internet costs, arguing that it will be the only way for the public, especially the vulnerable groups, to benefit from ICT innovations, digital financial services, communication and e-government services, among others.
The quality of service is one thing to connect and you're just connecting at 1 second and you're off. How reliable is the internet? We are looking at infrastructure. You talked about enrollment, you know, deployment, infrastructure deployment. It's one thing putting the infrastructure there, deploying it, but how efficient is it? Is it working? Is it just redundant?
Speaking during the release of the research findings regarding how some government institutions provide digital services, Lydia Naroga from the Internet Society Uganda chapter emphasized that internet connectivity should go beyond Kampala and the government should invest in reliable infrastructure to improve overall connectivity.
For me, I would look at the connecting in the digital world to be, it has to be meaningful connectivity. Service delivery, you know, has to be, people, it's not just having internet for the fun of it, but service provision. What value am I getting? We've seen programs now, everything you do is channeled through your national ID, it has a QR code, everything is being digitalized, you know, our driving permits, they have QR codes, QR codes, and all that. This is service delivery. But beyond us, who can afford?
This research was carried out in 13 districts across the country, including Kampala, Masaka, Kabale, Gulu, Arua, Mbarara, among others. They identified challenges such as lack of ICT skills among civil servants, limited resources to fully digitize hospitals and police stations, citing that police stations, especially those in rural areas, still record cases manually.
The access, for example, to things like Wi-Fi, we have made a few attempts here and there, but we found that there is a bit of a challenge that while you're asking people to go to a public available platform, for example, the one we developed through this work, the FIO platform, people will tell you, I have no access to internet. So imagine what would have happened if we had access to public Wi-Fi, for example, that is available by the public institutions.
Kata Agaya, one of the team leaders, also demanded that the government should lift a ban on Facebook because through it so many Ugandans can interact business-wise but also get to know about government development programs.
Well, the things like blocking certain platforms and making them inaccessible to the public. So why don't we just open them, you know? For example, what crime, for example, did Facebook really, really commit that's not open, that in other countries open but not in this country?
He further credited the government for the successful digital journey taken so far, which has saved the country trillions of shillings annually and the time that would have been spent on making services available to the public. Some of the achievements include accessing government services online, including e-tax payments, e-passports, digitalized national identification cards, among others. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.